Hi, guys. Hi, Rambo. What are you doing here?
Oh, I don't want to see my family right now.
Why? What happened?
Well, my sister ate my secret stash of candy, and I'm very upset right now.
I'm sorry, Rambo. Families can be very complicated, and some families sometimes struggle to get along. Siblings fight, and parents make mistakes. But the important part is, God designed families, and He gives us instructions in the Bible about how we can treat each other. That brings me to my main point. Because of Jesus, we can love our families. There's actually a story in the Bible about a family that didn't get things right. Sometimes they didn't treat each other very well, but God was still with them. And in the end, they do learn to love each other better.
Sounds great. Can we watch it, please?
Of course. Let's go.
God's story, Jacob and Esau. So part of God's story is about twin brothers, and it begins like this. Once, there were twins named Jacob and Esau, and they didn't get along. They actually started fighting before they were born. Then during birth, Esau came out first, but Jacob was holding onto his heel. That's not normal. And they even looked different. The Bible says Esau's body was covered in so much red hair, it was almost like he had clothes on. Jacob's skin was smooth. Well, they got even more different as they grew up. Esau hunted animals and spent time outside. Their dad, Isaac, was a big meat eater, so Esau was his favorite. Jacob, on the other hand, was a quiet guy who liked to stay indoors. Their mom, Rebecca, liked Jacob the best. The Bible doesn't talk much about Jacob and Esau as kids, but we do know Esau was lucky to be the oldest because he had what's called a birthright. That meant Esau would be in charge of their family, including all their money, land, and stuff. Jacob would probably have to work for his brother Esau, and their dad Isaac would give Esau a blessing, which means Isaac would ask God to take care of his oldest son Esau in an extra special way. Well, you probably think Esau was pretty excited about this, but he wasn't. In fact, one day he gave it up. He'd just returned from a hunting trip. Since he was out killing animals all day, he didn't have time to eat. He came home starving. Jacob was making stew, so Esau said, "Quick, give me some of that stew. I'm very hungry." Now, Jacob was a little sneaky, so he didn't just share the stew with his hungry brother, which would have been nice. Instead, he said, "First, sell me your birthright." And guess what? Esau said yes. It's a little like paying $1 million for a bowl of mushy soup. We don't know why Esau did that, but the Bible says he didn't care about the birthright. But later, when Isaac was really old and about to die, he wanted to ask God to take special care of his firstborn Esau. So he told Esau to go hunting and make him some tasty food, maybe for the last time. Now, Esau wanted the birthright, so he left right away to hunt. Meanwhile, Rebecca had heard Isaac and Esau talking, and remember, Jacob was her favorite. She wanted him to get the blessing. So she did something really sneaky. She told Jacob, "I will prepare tasty food for your father. You take it to your father to eat. Then he'll give you his blessing before he dies." See, Isaac was blind. She was telling Jacob to pretend he was Esau. But there was a slight problem with her plan. First off, Esau was hairy. So if Isaac touched Jacob's smooth skin, he would know the truth. The Bible says Esau had a certain smell too, which might be a polite way of saying he stunk. I mean, imagine how smelly a guy would be if he was always sweating and getting dead animal blood stuck on his clothes and matted in his hairy skin. And this was before deodorant. So even though Isaac was blind, he might smell Jacob or touch his smooth arm and know the truth. Well, Rebecca was sneaky like Jacob. She told Jacob to put sheepskin on his arms and wear some of Esau's smelly clothes. Now Isaac would never know. And even though Isaac wondered why the voice sounded like Jacob, guess what? The trick worked. Jacob got the blessing. Now Esau would have to work for him. As you might imagine, Esau was furious. In fact, Rebecca had to help Jacob run away so Esau wouldn't kill him. What's really crazy about this story is Jacob messed up big time, but he really did get God's blessing. Esau even forgave him later. We don't know why God let this happen, but the truth is we all mess up sometimes, and God still wants us to be part of his story. And that's the story of Jacob and Esau.
Wow, that was an interesting story, but I don't understand. It seems like the family did some things right and some things wrong.
That's right, Rambo. One of the reasons I like this story is it reminds me of me and my family. Sometimes we do things right, and sometimes we do things wrong. The important thing is that we must ask Jesus to help us do better. The Bible says in 1 Peter 3 verse 8 that we must love one another as brothers and sisters and be kind and humble with each other. Well, Rambo, I hope you can find it in your heart to forgive your sister.
Yeah, I guess it doesn't help to stay mad. But I think this time I'm gonna get enough candy for both of us.
Wow, that's great, Rambo. Well, guys, that brings us to the end of our story. But before we go, let's praise our Father in heaven as a family. Let's go.
Yours is the name high above any other. Yours is the kingdom forever you reign. Yours is the power that lifted us out of the grave. Hands up! Yours is the heart that is beating inside us. Yours is the glory and all of the fame. And yours is the love that you poured down on us. We're rising up to sing your praise. To the King Almighty, to the one who saved, be glory and honor for all our days. With our hands toward heaven and our voices raised, to the King Almighty we give all our praise. Yeah! Yours is the whole earth and everything in it. Yours are the stars that you spoke into place. And yours are the shouts of your sons and daughters.
Forgiven, so we give to him the highest praise. It's the greatest,
Well, guys, wasn't that just amazing to praise God? Let's end off the day in prayer. Please close your eyes. Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you for the amazing ability to have family. I pray that you would help us treat them right with respect and with love. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Please remember to ask your parents to download the activity sheet on our website, nlchurch.co.za. Thanks, guys. Enjoy the rest of your day. Goodbye.
Bye.